Hello guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Tausif Siddiqui and in this video I will show you how to make a budget drone using KK2.15 flight controller and FlySky CT6B budget transmitter receiver. So here I have chassis which is already mounted and I am using 1000 kV brushless motors and 30 amp ESCs which I have already mounted on the chassis. So I will show you how to do the connections. And I'm using 2200 mAh battery, that is 2.2 Ah battery, lithium ion. So let's start by connecting the ESCs to brushless motors. Then I'll show you how to connect the ESC to transmitter receiver and KK2.15. So first let's connect the brushless motors to ESC. So I will keep everything aside. If you look closely, you will find that around 3 wires are coming out of the brushless motors and 3 wires are coming out of the ESCs. The wires are of red, yellow and black color, and from ESC you will find all 3 blue colors. But at the back side you will find that around 2 wires are going in, thick wires, black and red. These are the battery wires. So first I will connect red wire to the wire coming out of ESCs connected to red. Now black wire to black, which is the last wire of ESC, and the signal wire obviously will go to the signal wire of ESC. So now the motor is going to rotate in the clockwise direction. If you want to change the direction of the rotation of brushless motor, then you have to change the wiring, then you have to connect red to black, black to red. This is how you have to do, then the motor is going to rotate in the anti-clockwise direction. So now let's connect the other one. So this one I want to connect it to the anti-clockwise direction. So now let's connect the black wire to the wire coming out of ESCs connected to the black wire, red wire to black wire, and the signal wire will go to the middle wire of the ESC, which is the signal wire. Now again I have to connect it properly, that is red to red and black to black, because two motors are rotated in the clockwise direction and two in anti-clockwise direction, and signal wire will go to signal wire. Now this wire and this motor is going to rotate in the anti. Now I will connect this ESC to motor. I want this to be anti-clockwise, so I will connect red to black and black to red, and signal wire will go to the middle wire of the ESC. So this is how you have to do the connection. The wire coming from the positive terminal is the first wire, and the wire coming from the negative terminal is the last wire. So you just have to change the wiring. You have to connect the red to black and black to red. Now this motor is going to rotate in the anti-clockwise direction. This motor is going to rotate in the clockwise direction because the positive terminal of the battery is going to the positive of the motor, and the negative terminal of the battery is going to the negative of the motor, and the signal wire is going to the signal wire of the ESC. Now you will find that there are around 3 wires coming out with female jumper heads, and these are called as signal wires. Through this we are going to send the PWM signals. Here also you will find that around 3 pins are coming. One is brown, red and yellow. Yellow is the signal wire. Red and brown are the positive and negative terminals. Red is positive and black or the brown is negative. So this is we are going to connect to the controller board. The positive and negative wire of the ESCs are actually connected to the base plate of the drone. So when you buy the kit, you will get this type of plates. These are called as base plate, and on this you will find that there are 2 signs available, positive and negative. So you have to connect the red wire to the positive and the black wire to negative terminal of the base plate. So you will find that every red and black wire is connected to the proper assigned terminals. And now let's connect the signal wires to the circuit board. So let's start connecting the ESCs to KK2.5. If you have a closer look, you will find that there are three pins in series. It's written S 5 volt and minus. S stand for signal, 5 volt stand for 5 volt, minus stand for ground. So when you look at the wires coming out, the signal wires coming out of the ESC, you will find that there are three pins, yellow, red and brown. Yellow stand for signal, red is 5 volt and brown is the ground wire. So let's start connecting the ESC wires. If you see at the KK2.1, there is a small arrow showing that it is forward. So this is the front side of the controller, so I'm going to place it like this way. Now I have kept it facing in the forward direction. Now let's take this wire, the signal wire of this ESC, and insert it to the first port. Now let's go and take the second wire. Now the third one, connect the third one. Now the fourth one. So this is how you connect the ESC signal wires to KK2.5. Now let's connect the receiver to the main controller. So the receiver requires 5 volt to get powered. So I am using female jumpers with red, black and white wires. Red stands for positive, black is negative or the ground, white is the signal wire. On the KK2.15, you will find that there are around 3 pins in series. So it's written minus 5 volt and signal. So accordingly I am going to connect it. So channel 1 will go to first one. Now goes the second one. So this is how you have to connect it. And now accordingly all the channel wires will go to the receiver. First channel, second channel and third channel. For fourth channel I am using a separate wire. And let's connect this to the fourth channel. So this is how you have to connect the signal wires of the receiver to KK2.1. So this is how you have to connect all the components. Now let's calibrate the controller to KK2.1. Before calibration, first we need to remove all the propellers. So now let's start calibrating. For that we need to remove all the wires of the receiver and then remove all the wires of the ESCs and now connect. To calibrate, you have to connect the ESC wire of the motor to channel number 3. You have to connect it accordingly, properly, signal wire to signal wire, positive to positive, ground to ground, and then connect the batteries, take the throttle to the fullest, then turn on the receiver. You will get a beeping sound, and then slowly bring the throttle to the lowest position, and now it is calibrated. Let's see how it works. So similarly you have to calibrate all the ESCs by connecting it into the channel number 3 and then taking the throttle to the full, then turning it on, then you will get beeping sound, then bring it to the lowest, then again you will get a beeping sound. That means it is calibrated. Once done calibrating all the ESCs, now connect all the wires again as we have done previously. Channel 1 to channel 1, channel 2, 3 and 4 to 2, 3, 4. Once done connecting all the signal wires to the main flight controller, now let's check if the device got calibrated properly. For that, first we need to press the first and the last button of the flight controller and then connect the battery wire. It will show the throttle pass through, then you have to turn on the throttle and then raise the throttle. If all the motors turn on at same time, that means it got calibrated properly. So done calibrating. So first we have to select what type of board we are using. So first press the menu button, then go to load motor layout, then press OK button, then the fourth button, then go to quadcopter X mode, press yes. So this is how the layout will look like. First motor rotate in the clockwise, second anti-clockwise, third clockwise, fourth anti-clockwise, and done with this. And see if all the motors are rotating properly. The first motor, according to the controller board, this should rotate in the clockwise direction. Second one should rotate in the anti-clockwise, third again clockwise, fourth one again anti-clockwise. So this is how all the motors should rotate. Then that means your all the connections are proper. And once done, press back button, again back. Now search for ACC calibration. In ACC calibration, we are doing select ACC calibration. It says keep it on the plane surface, then press continue. Wait for some time, it will take few seconds to calibrate. Calibration, and calibration is done. Continue, calibration succeed, done. This is how we have to calibrate gyro sensor. Now let's test the drone. So we are done with everything, let's fly and see how it works.
Hey!